My name is Yaw Skyface, and this is my one-on-one with GhanaMusic.com. My real name is Isaac Mensah. I come from Ebitifikro in the Eastern region. Education background, I went to school at Takoradi Polytechnic, now Takoradi Technical University. Growing up, my dad was a church elder, so is my mom, so it was kind of strict, but I got a chance to hang out with friends who were doing music, so entertainment was also a big part of my life growing up. My siblings, none of them really liked entertainment, so it was just me. So during the early stages of my career, I was with a group of young men who were all doing music. So we had a studio where there was a rapper, there was a singer, there was somebody doing raga, whatever. And I wanted to fit in. I tried rapping, it wasn't working, but I was a visual arts student and I like cameras. So the only way I could be accepted was to do something relevant. So I was like, okay, when they finish the music, I think they need a video. So I'll handle that part without any knowledge in shooting music videos. So that's how I began investing a little time into learning how or what it takes to make music videos. I think growing up, because I wasn't really static at one place, I was moving around a lot, like staying with my father's friends, school. So I got to see a lot of places in Ghana, to be specific, more than anybody in my year, in my age mates. Like, so I was traveling a lot. So when I grew up, sometimes I want to create a concept. I can quickly remember some scenes or some location I saw when I was young, and then it helps. It really helps. I think right after school, I got posted to Tamale for my national service. And then at that time, I just came back from school. Financially, I wasn't fit. I already started shooting. So I think I got my first gig, which got me a little cash. So I just did the math. I was like, okay, fine. I can either go and do the service or start working like full work and make some paper. So I just did the math and I was like, okay, fine. If my passion, if my art can earn me something, then I'm not going to go to the tunnel again. I'm going to start by working for myself. And that's how come I got stuck with music videos. They say in Ghana, Abraham Ohinijan, Gio, Esihine, Step, all those guys were guys that growing up, we saw their works and inspired, especially me, to do what I'm doing today. And then internationally to Colin Tilly, David Myers, like there are a lot of big international directors where once their name is on a video, we know that, oh, this video is dope. So it inspired me to also create that kind of brand where whenever you see my name on a video, at least you could expect something cool. And that's what we've been trying to do for this past years. Yeah, Skyface, Yaw is mine. If you are from Ghana, you know Yaw is a Thursday born. So I was born on Thursday. And Skyface is a high school nickname. You adopt one and you just move with it. And I've been using it for quite a number of years now. So when I started to brand myself, I was like, okay, I could use just Skyface for easy identification. Because as I said, my real name is Isaac. If I have to say, oh, directed by Isaac, that means I'll be blocking a lot of chances whoever wants to do Isaac next time or whoever is called Isaac next time. So I was like, okay, let me use Skyface. And then to localize it more, let me just add my local name, that is Yaw. So Yaw Skyface. First, it was Skyface Yaw. And I have to switch it, Yaw Skyface. I'll say since 2009. So that's a lot above 10 years. Yeah. A lot about 10 years. A 12-year-old me shouldn't do anything different from what I did back then, because I don't know how amazing it would have been if I was doing something else. Whatever I did, all the mistakes I did, everything I think contributed to who I am today and where I'm going. Because it's different if I'm done. I think I'm not even getting started. So everything is in line. 12-year-old me should just follow the same step. Maybe should read more, because I didn't like reading at all. Yeah, so maybe he should read more. Yeah. Okay, so I have a very interesting story, because growing up, it was in the era where Sakawa and all those things were really common, and I was spending so much time in the cafe, but I wasn't doing whatever everybody was doing. I was just watching tutorials on YouTube, because I didn't go to film school. So I remember one day I came back home very late. My dad was telling my mom he suspects I'm doing whatever the guys are doing, and they couldn't stop me because it was like a passion. So they would try to advise you, try to discourage you from doing it. So because of the mindset, I didn't also really let them know what I was really up to. So almost about 5 years into my career, my dad knows I'm a graduate. I did graphics in school, so I'm working, but I couldn't pinpoint the exact thing I was doing, because obviously my work always deal with computers, so it was kind of the same. Until social media started getting popular, my little brothers and sisters also getting on social media. So, you know, suggestions, your brother, this dude, they got to know, is it the same person we know? And then there was a picture, and then they started convincing them more, but they were still not 100% convinced I'm the same person. And my parents too didn't know any work of mine, though they've been seeing it, they don't know I'm the same person. So I think when Ebony died, so rest in peace, when she died, you know, her views went really viral. So that was a point where they actually realized, oh, so he's the same person we've been seeing. And at that point, I think everything was okay already. Everything was okay already, so they could just accept but do nothing. The first ever mainstream video I shot was for I1. That was around 2010 or 2011. Yeah, I Won't Miss You, which was shot in my hometown, so it was a kind of it was like an honor that he called me to shoot a music video in my own hometown for the very first time. My toughest, I wouldn't say toughest, but maybe most challenging in my early days would be shooting The Crime Coco Sakura. Because at the time, I think that was his big project after his major hit. He was coming back very big. He has Sakode on there too. Sakode too at the time has just returned from BET. So there was a lot of pressure on me to prove. So we had to put in a lot of resources, a lot of thinking, a lot of little experience here and there to make it work. And it wasn't easy, but I think he liked it. His fans liked it, and I liked it personally, so yeah, it was worth it. It was worth a struggle. 10, 15 years, 20 years, maybe 40 years. I'm just trying to make sure we bridge the gap between, or we change the mindset between Ghana video directors and what people think of us as compared to Nigerians or other video directors from other parts of the world. So myself and my team have a production company called Upstairs Media. What we are trying to do is to produce high quality music video for not the price we always assume it could be, just because if we have to lay back and also say, okay, this supposed to be this way, and that means we can't create what we really need to. So in 10, 20, 30, 40 years time from now, I just want us to create and create and create to the point that people will look back and be like, okay, first it wasn't like this, but thanks to this group of people, or thanks to this number of people, or thanks to Sky, his crew, his friends, other directors, now Ghana music video directors can be recognized, and then the quality of the music videos too is good and on the same level with the other people or our other competitions. Yeah. Music video, just like any other thing, it's a content. just like movie, it's a content. I don't think every movie have nude in them. So same way, I don't think every music video has nudes or guns or violence in them. Now, I am someone who also puts, I can't sit here and deny that I don't put nude or I don't put half naked women in my music videos. But sometimes, where are you putting them? If you're putting them at the right places, I think it's fine. Because the same people who criticize music video directors for doing that, especially TV stations, they are the same people who show foreign content with people wearing bikini and kissing in there. I don't remember shooting a music video and you see somebody kissing someone, but we have a lot of telenovelas on TVs. Because I remember an incident where an artist took, I won't mention the station, but an artist took his music video to one of these stations, and he called me and like, oh, they said there's nudity in so and so minute. And I was like, wait, I don't see anything wrong with someone wearing a bikini, or it's not even, you know, when we, the bikini said we have types of bikini. The ladies will tell you they have one that covers every part of the body, just that maybe it's not long, and they are using it rightfully. And then we even, because we also know if we leave it clean, it's going to create a lot of questions. We added effects on it so that you don't really pay attention to. And then they are rejecting the work because of that scene. But same TV station, I saw them showing a foreign production with women swimming at the beaches, wearing bikini, a man kissing. Like, and I think it's normal. I think it's normal. So I can't condemn and say it's wrong. Maybe if we use it well, it will definitely fit in the narrative. Because if I have to make a scene where somebody's sleeping on the bed, I'm a storyteller. I can't let a person wear a suit and tie and cover him or herself. So the person definitely have to be in lingerie or something. So I think it's the content, or it's a context in which we are putting some kind of costumes, that will make people criticize it. But if it's being placed well, I think the credit should be given. Medica, Ghana woman, a billionaire, shooting. Maybe my hand, but I shouldn't hurt too much. I think I would like to rush into the future to see what's coming. Someone who can use their mind to control everything. I think every parent wants the best for his or her child. But the most important thing is, the best thing you want for the child is maybe to earn a living, get a good job, because it's a good job that will bring a good living. But if you allow your child to follow his dreams, his passion, definitely that passion will turn into something good, and it will definitely bring the living or the kind of life you want for him or her. So if you see your kid has a passion in something, I think you need to encourage the kid and help, or give him the resources that he needs. Because the earlier, the better. If he starts doing it at the early stages, it becomes like a lifestyle. I think I will encourage every young upcoming movie maker, filmmaker, to learn hard and don't take your work for granted. Just learn hard. Just try to improve your quality. Because one problem we are facing is, whatever you create here, now there's internet. I mean, somebody can watch you from the States, from London, from anywhere, any part of the world. So your quality has to be standard to what they know is quality. That's the only way the work can cross over. So your quality has to be on top notch every day. So they need to create every day. Yeah, we have a lot of music videos coming out, but next year, I think I did a movie last 2 years. So next year will be like 3 years. And then I'm planning to come back with another feature. So I wish when the time comes, I get the support I need. My business number is on my Instagram, Facebook. Yeah, and it's the same number across for about 10 years. Same number. Never changed it. Oh my God. I should say this as fast as I can. Skyface has a face with a Scarface. That was four, right?